Hey guys, it's raining. Obviously, it's a pretty miserable day, so I won't be going to the theaters. But anyway, it's October 2nd, 2015. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcat. The biggest news is really an announcement that we now have 94,600,000 people not working in this country. Okay, that increase in August. In August, it was right around 94 million, but it increased by more than 579,000 to 94.6 million people in this country not working. That's absolutely incredible. It's unbelievable. It's pretty much the highest number we've had since 1977. Of course, we've had a lot more, the population's grown, so that you will naturally see that number go up. But still, that's absolutely incredible. You know, it's... even with these job numbers, it's incredible. And there's been some reports that the job numbers weren't really that good. We produced less than 200,000 new jobs last month. And, you know, here's the deal. They need to start measuring the quality of the jobs, because if they're just measuring part-time, temporary jobs that don't pay a living wage, then, you know, does it really matter that much? Are we really creating jobs that really impact people's futures, people's lives? It's just a thought. I mean, do you think we should go about changing the way we calculate unemployment in this country, how we calculate job creation in this country? You know, and what about underemployment? You know, if you have a bachelor's degree and you're working two part-time jobs, are you really fully and gainfully employed? I mean, come on, let's just be a little honest here, but there's no political incentive to do so. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching. I want to show you a little bit more of some of the things I have going on. Alright guys, here's a little update on my flashlight, the Bushnell flashlight. The main feature still works, the main light works, the main mode works. The blood tracker mode works as well. A little blue light. But the red light no longer works. It's a $25 flashlight and the red light no longer works. Not that I would have probably used it that much, but still, it's worth noting. I've had it for like a month or so and the red light stopped working. So. Alright, here it is, the Bushnell TRKR flashlight, the T250L. It has 250 lumens on its highest setting. And again, the regular light works. The regular light works just fine. The blue light works, but the red light no longer works. I think I'm going to wait a little bit longer to start doing these reviews. Because some of these items, you know, they work fairly well in the beginning, but then after a month of regular use, you start to notice things going wrong. Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. I'm currently waiting, as you can tell. But anyway, I've been listening to a lot of different types of music. You guys know I love the female voice, a beautiful, strong female voice. I love the femininity and that type of sound. I think that a soft sound could be a strong sound. And it's a beautiful sound. I just love listening to music being performed by females. It's always been pretty much my favorite. I can relate to it on a different level. It's like seeing the world from a different perspective. You know, that's pretty cool. That's something I'm interested in. I'm always interested in experiencing different things. Because, you know, when a man sings, he's singing from one perspective. But when a woman sings, she's singing from another perspective. I know that a lot of people tend to prefer to listen to the artists of the same gender, because that artist is singing from a perspective that they can relate more to. But I'm just open to different ways of viewing the world. But anyway, I love the sound of the female voice. Zella Day is an artist I've been listening to a lot. She's wonderful. I love her singles, Ophelia and Hypnotic. I bought her CD, the MP3, off of Amazon. I've been enjoying it, listening to it, enjoying it. She's one of those artists where she has this beautiful, soft voice, and I just find it to be very sexy. I find it to be very beautiful. It's something that really appeals to me. And she can actually sing, whereas a lot of people on the radio, they can only sing in the studio, so to speak. She's one of those artists where if you listen to the album, it sounds wonderful, but then if you look at a live video of her singing, she still has that wonderful voice. She's not relying too much on some track, and you can just hear her voice, her real voice, and this is wonderful. So her name is Zella Day. Check her out. Megan Myers is another artist I've been checking out. Megan Myers. She's a singer-songwriter. Both of them are singer-songwriters, but Zella Day is more of an alternative type of performer. Yeah, I think they both are really. But who else? It's a lot. I downloaded that new album by Disturbed, and I just love it. I love the balance with that group, because I'm used to them really going hard. You know, it's sort of a harder rock band, but I like how they sort of put in like a ballad here, and they sort of present a different good variety of the type of music that they can do, and they show a good range. And that's something I really enjoy in a lot of artists, when they're able to show that range. Other things going on, what else? Breaking Benjamin. I've been listening to Breaking Benjamin, a new CD as well. So yeah, I've been going to Amazon.com and getting some new music. And it's important for me, you know, especially when I'm not really out in back in an urban environment, there's not a lot going on. I rely a lot more on music now. So hopefully I'll be able to get to the point where I can actually watch live music. Anyway. No.
Used to, when I was growing up there, you never see a deer. For the last 10, 12 years, they're nothing but pests.
They're pests? You don't like them?
Oh, I like them, but there's so many of them. They're dangerous.
Yeah.
Especially when you're driving. They're open.
Okay.
And I like the deer, but there's just so many of them. They're dangerous.
Yeah. I hear what you're saying. I haven't seen one on the road yet, but... wildlife all over Pikeville. All right, guys, thank you for watching, thank you for listening, and don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for today. Bye.